Hey, what's up? It's Dr. here. Welcome back to my degree program. I'm at Osaka Castle here. And yeah. So let's talk about what I've done this week. I've been working on supporting the PDF export feature, and I finished implementing it. It's available on iOS and Android. And I've implemented a UI here, so you can export PDF from the note information screen, and you can tap export as a PDF button here, and you can see the printer screen comes up. So you can save it as PDF. And the next improvement is UI. So the app, especially on tablets, it used to freeze when you change the device orientation from portrait to landscape or landscape to portrait. It freezes for a few seconds, but I managed to fix it. I found that when changing the device orientation, a massive amount of re-rendering happens. So it freezes for a few seconds while re-rendering the whole components. So I found that there was a PR pull request on restyle. This is a performance improvement, and this improves significantly a performance by reducing re-rendering when detecting the screen size change. Because by making breakpoints as optional, I mean, so I have some responsive themes. Responsive theme styles that can change based on the screen size. But it's a minor styles. Like as you can see, it has a slight narrow line between the sidebar and the notice and the editor. You can see the lines, separated lines here, and they should be only appeared on the tablet layout. But I found that it doesn't. It is not so destructive on the phone layout, because it's the edge of the screen, so you don't see. It's not annoying. I decided to make it visible on both phone and tablet layouts. So I could remove the breakpoints from the UI themes. So I could reduce re-rendering when changing the device orientation. So it significantly improved the UI performance. So when you change the device orientation, it smoothly changed the layout, as you can see. Yeah, so it's great. And this version, 5.1.0, is now available on beta. So you can try it by test flight and Google Play Store open testing channel. So please try it and let me know what you think. Next up is the migration. So I've been working on migrating my code base from Flow to TypeScript, and I've done doing that on the server-side code and the mobile app. But this time I started working on it, working on the desktop app. Yeah. And I used Flow to DS to convert my Flow code base to TypeScript, but there were so many errors. As you can see, I've got 2,500 errors in 264 files. That's overwhelming. And so the problem was the code base had some untyped coffee scripts because I made Inkdrop based on the automator to accomplish flexible key maps and package system and the theming features and so on. So there were so many coffee scripts code base, and I needed to convert them into JavaScript. So it cannot be directly converted to TypeScript at the moment. So I decided to leave them as a JavaScript for now. Then I worked on fixing errors, and now I've got there are 600 errors now. So I'll keep working on it. Next is as I mentioned, Inkdrop is Inkdrop borrowed some Atom code, and the Atom editor is no longer maintained. So their internal modules are also not maintained anymore. So they are already obsolete. So I needed to replace them with something active. So first I worked on libraries like FS Plus and Keymap module, and it is for so they use underscore plus, which is developed by the Atom team, and it is based on underscore with some extensions. And underscore is a bloated library, so the bundle size increases significantly, so it affects launch speed. So I needed to drop underscore. And there is a useful article that is about you don't need lodash or underscore. So it has a bunch of tips that replaces lodash and underscore utility functions with Node.js or JavaScript native functions, as you can see here. So you can replace a chunk function with a simple function, like so. So I managed to replace underscore functions with native ones. So it could reduce the bundle size significantly. And other modules still depend on underscore and or lodash. So I will update them as well. And next one is that's also important. Inkdrop uses a JSON format. It's a coffee script object notation, and it's a JavaScript. It's a coffee script version of JSON, and this depends on a whole, the whole mod, it depends on the entire CoffeeScript library, so it's a massive library. And yeah, so it also affects the launch speed. So I wanted to replace CSON with another format like JSON and YAML, and I came up with a feasible solution that is to convert config files from CSON to YAML, because the both YAML and CSON have a similar format. They are most compatible, so you can simply convert CSON files to YAML by making a simple script. So I made a simple converter to achieve that. So you can see, if you, let's say you have a CSON file like this, so it has a theme key which has an array value. But it doesn't have a separator comma here. So this script adds commas for array items. So that makes compatible. That makes the Inkdrop config files compatible with YAML. So it can be simply migrated to YAML format. That is great. That's it. So thanks for watching, and have a productive day.